In this video, we'll be looking at how to quickly generate a crowd in Houdini. We're just going to make a new shelf tab here, a crowd shelf, and let's click on the simulate tool. Hit the enter key twice. Since we have an empty scene, Houdini will generate a default setup for us. So, our default crowd setup has 1,000 agents. Each agent has an 8,000 poly count. And keep in mind that all the animation deformations are happening real time. None of it is pre-baked. Let's turn on real-time toggle, and we're going to extend the timeline to 1,000 frames. Click on Apply. Hit the up arrow key to play. And we'll stop the playback and take a look at the network that was generated. The nodes have been color-coded for our convenience. Pink ones are states and behaviors. Orange are trigger nodes. Blue are transition nodes. The crowdsource node references the agent primitives, which are the guys we see in the scene. And the crowdsolver node, which implements the crowd system. You'll find control parameters for agents, avoidance, terrain, and others. Let's go back to frame 1. And we'll go back up to object level, so hit the U key. And now hit the L key to lay out the nodes, and we'll take a look at the nodes here. So here we have the mocap cycles for stand, rest, and walk, which our agent will use. And here's our bake cycle node, which bakes out the animation files to disk for performance purposes. CrowdSim is where we were looking at our nodal network earlier. And CrowdSource, let's double click to go inside, is where we can specify controls for our agents. We can, for example, set the number of agents. Let's make it 100. And we'll turn off the ortho grid. And we're going to change layout to formation. You can set the number of rows and columns you want. And you can adjust the amount of spacing as well. And let's play to see them move. Hit the up arrow key to toggle stop, and we'll go back to frame 1. We're going to click on the input of the crowdsource node, so hit the tab key and type grid, and then hit the entry key to select it. We're going to change the grid parameters. And we'll set the rows and columns to 20. And we're going to change layout back to random. And we're going to use a tool called Paint Density, which will allow us to interactively place our agents by painting directly on our grid terrain. Make sure that our crowdsource object is selected and hit the Enter key. Hold down Shift and left mouse button click and drag to change the brush size. And we can start painting. Changing the foreground color values will affect the density of agents distributed on our grid. And we're done painting, so let's go back up to object level, hit the U key, and we'll play it back to see our crowd take a stroll. And this is just an example of some of the crowd shelf tools inside Houdini. Stay tuned for more in future videos.